So this week's video is coming from inside of the RV project. For those of you that are new to the channel, I built out a legitimate home theater inside of an RV. Currently, you know, just having people come to the house to listen to the system, it doesn't make a whole lot of logistical sense. But having a deployable home theater solution that's gives you a true home theater experience and gives you an idea of what's possible in your own home, it's more doable in this situation. And I'm actually having DTSX and Atmos, so basically a full immersive surround system. So it's really exciting, it's fun, and I'm having a lot of fun with it. But the reason I'm doing it from inside the RV project now is because they SVS just released the PB-3000s. Now, I got in touch with SVS years ago, and I said, hey, can you do an affiliate program? And one of the things I'd like to do is I'd like to hear every ported SVS subwoofer. And one of the subs that I wasn't able to do that with was the PB-12 Plus. So the PB-12 Plus was a 12-inch driver, 800 watts, and you know it's a good subwoofer, but the reason I never had them send it out was because it was going to be replaced. And so they're replacing it with the PB-3000. So the PB-3000, instead of being a 12-inch driver, it's a 13-inch driver. And these are the PB-4000s. They are a 13.5-inch driver. So it's just slightly smaller than the PB-4000. It's 800 watts RMS, 2,500 watts peak. It's going to have the app just like the PB-4000s and just like the PB-16 Ultra. And so it's a really cool package. It's the least expensive ported subwoofer that you can get into that has the app, that has, you know, variable ports, that, you know, has all the upper end of SVS features. You can get that now, and the price is at $1,399. And so I'm excited for it, and the reason that it has anything to do with the RV project is the PB-4000s, they're just a little bit longer, and so it kind of sticks out in the aisle a little bit. And I can actually fit the PB-16 Ultras in here. They're not that much bigger than the PB-4000s. But the thing is, they make walking by here just a little bit, you know, cumbersome. So the PB-2000s weren't that big a deal in here. But I think the PB-3000s are going to just be like a Goldilocks fit for inside of this project. And I need to do a video on small rooms and big subs, but that's another topic. But for me, the PB-3000 is a great solution for a lot of people, because there's a lot of people that look at the PB-16 Ultras or the PB-4000s and are like, I want that sub. And they go buy that sub, and then they realize later that they need duals, okay? And when you've spent $2,500 on a subwoofer and then you realize you need two of them, that just brought your budget to $5,000. And so that's kind of an issue. When I first heard duals, before I heard duals, I didn't realize how important they were. I finally heard them. Wow, this is important. And then I went back to a single, and I'm like, wow, duals are really important. So when I reviewed the PB-16 Ultras, my big advice there was split your budget and get the dual PB-12 Plus, because I think you'll get a better overall experience. You know, I know that the PB-16 Ultra is a better sub than the PB-12 Plus, there's no doubt. But you really need duals. Duals are really that important. And what the PB-3000s allow is for someone that has the budget for a single PB-16 Ultra, instead they can get dual PB-3000s, still get the app. If they get all the functionality that they get with the higher-end SVS subwoofers at the lowest price that you can do that with. So, you know, the PB-1000s and the PB-2000s, those are very... they're great subs. They offer a lot of dynamics and things like that, but they get you kind of in the subwoofer game. And I always tell people, you know, bass is addictive. I'm just letting you know. And it is. I'm surprised at the amount of people that buy, you know, dual PB-1000s and tell me they're stepping up to the 4000s. I mean, it's crazy. It happens more than I would expect. But it's one of those things where as you go up in the range, so when you go from the PB-1000 to the PB-2000, you go from a sub that goes down really strong to about 20, 21 hertz and then trails off a little bit, okay, which is really good, way better than most subs, okay? And then you get to the PB-2000 and it doesn't do that at all. It's just straight. It goes all the way down to about 14 hertz in room. And so according to your ears, I can hear down to about 17 hertz. According to your ears, you get down to 17 hertz and I can't hear any more bass under that. I can measure it, I just can't hear it. So it's bottomless. There's no limit to that sub. It's a bottomless sub. It's a full range subwoofer. So you're not missing anything when you go to the PB-2000. Beyond that, a lot of the response graphs look the same. So the SVS sound, when it comes to ported subwoofers, is very consistent. I know what to expect. I would be very shocked to get the PB-3000 out here and hear something that I don't expect. It's a very unified sound across their subwoofers. So in that sense, what do you get when you go from a PB-2000 to a 3000 or a 4000 or a 16 Ultra? As you go with increased wattage within the SVS line, it's not so much about louder bass, which is what a lot of people assume. But you can go louder. I don't want to, you know, dispute that. You can absolutely go louder. But it gives you more dynamic headroom, more punch, and more. The bass has more traction within that same listening volume, with the same envelope of sound you'd normally listen to. And so what does that translate to? Well, when you're watching scenes like The Accountant or Hacksaw Ridge, the bass is just more tactile. It's more authoritative. It hits you in the chest more at the same volume levels. And so it's a cooler experience. And I did have some people in here the other night listening to this system that had never heard it before. And a lot of people were remarking, wow, it's really comfortable. Like it's loud and you can feel it and it's deep, but it's not uncomfortable. You're not like wanting to plug your ears or anything. So that's one of the things that you get out of an SVS sub is, you know, they're ported subs. They go really deep. They're really strong, but they're also really comfortable. And so it's not a situation where you're going to get headaches and things like that. I don't. And I'm real sensitive to that kind of thing. So the PB-3000, I think, is a great entry into the higher end of SVS bass and gives you all the bells and whistles that you get with the 4000 and the 16 Ultra series, but at a more attainable price. And so I think that they really hit the nail on the head. I wasn't expecting a 13-inch driver. I was expecting a 12-inch driver, so that's exciting. And I think it's going to fit great in here because these are just a little bit deep, and being able to have a shorter sub is just going to make it a little nicer to get around in here. I'm not doing too bad as far as floor space, but every inch counts in something like this. It's still going to deliver that thunderous punch that I want people to experience. But, you know, just going to give me a little bit more room. So for this particular project, I think it's going to be a Goldilocks. Again, I can fit the PB-16 Ultras in here. They're just like an inch longer than the PB-4000s. An even more impressive experience. But I think that the 3000s are going to do a great job in here. I can't wait to hear them. I'm finally hearing the last ported box sub that SVS has available. I'm really excited about that. And again, if you're looking for deals, check out their outlet. You might want to look for the PB-12 Plus if you're really looking for a deal. If they still have those in stock, chances are they're going to be much cheaper than normal. And also, for those of you that are unaware, the SVS outlet, you still get 5-year unconditional, 5-year driver analog electronics warranty. So you're covered for 5 years. Including the amp, which the amp is the part that, you know, if it's going to go bad, that usually ends up being the part. And that goes for subwoofers of any brand, which is why you'll see some subwoofer manufacturers give you a shorter amp warranty over the entire subwoofer. But you get a full 5 years with SVS. You also get 1 year trade up. And so if you get a PB-2000s out of the outlet and you want to do a trade up, they give you full retail price, which you paid less shipping. And so within a year. So it's kind of a cool upgrade option that a lot more people take advantage of than I expected. You get all that and you still get free shipping with the outlet stuff. So there's really not a lot of difference between their new and their outlet products as far as warranty and things like that go. So definitely check that out. I'll put that in the links down in the description below. And again, if you haven't subscribed already, please do. And please hit the bell. My next video is going to be very time sensitive. And trust me, you're going to want to be on that. So anyway, I'll see you guys here shortly. And thanks so much for watching. And please subscribe.